This is Ian Cameron for the Odds HQ YouTube channel and odds.com. We have no NBA games today during this recording as I'm recording it here on this Friday, but that doesn't mean we can't give you an update on the NBA playoffs and where things stand right now with the NBA, of course, currently taking this 2-3 day break. The NBA playoffs will resume on Saturday, August 29th. That has been announced. So I decided let's do a video and let's take a look at where all of these NBA playoff first round series stand right now, because obviously some of them have already finished. In fact, we're going to have the first second round series beginning this weekend with the Boston Celtics and the Toronto Raptors facing off in what should be a phenomenal second round series. But let's give you a little bit of a rundown, see where we're at. In the Eastern Conference, we know the Celtics and the Raptors have already moved on, as well as the Miami Heat taking care of business against the Indiana Pacers. The only Eastern Conference series left is the Milwaukee Bucks taking on the Orlando Magic, and Milwaukee leading that series 3-1. It's really a situation where it's just a question of when, not if, the Milwaukee Bucks finish off the Orlando Magic. I would expect there's a pretty good chance it ends in Game 5 in their next game taking place this weekend. You look at it, Milwaukee finally has really clamped down defensively the last couple, done a better job. I mean, Orlando shot the lights out early in the series, which allowed them to basically get on the board with the one victory they had in Game 1 of this series. But other than that, we know Milwaukee, certainly the deeper team, the better defensive team, is definitely more of an array of weapons offensively. For the Magic, it's been far too reliant in this series on Vucevic and a couple other guys. I mean, Evan Fournier's had a really bad series for them, and they couldn't afford that if they had any shot to pull off a mammoth upset here. So for Milwaukee, it's just a question of when they advance. We turn our attention now to the Western Conference, and that's where things are a lot more interesting right now as things stand. You've got the Portland Trail Blazers and the LA Lakers, with the Lakers up 3-1. Pretty safe to say that series looks like it's pretty much done. Damian Lillard, we know, is done for the Portland Trail Blazers. He's already left the bubble in Orlando and made his way back home to tend to the injury that he is dealing with, spend time with his kids as well. So poor Damian Lillard's time with the Portland Trail Blazers and participating is done. And you're seeing this Portland Trail Blazers team that just, you know, battled their guts out. Every game was like a must-win game for them since the NBA restart began in late July. They look like they're finally hitting that wall physically, mentally. You know, CJ, people forget too, Yusuf Nurkic is coming back from an injury, and I think you can tell he's sort of, I don't want to say he's winded because that makes it sound like he's not kept himself in good shape, but you know what I mean. I mean, you've been out for months, and now all of a sudden you're playing a game every other day, and you're playing these intense games and these big minutes like he has, and he looks like he's struggling a little bit. You know, he's missing a ton of layups and putbacks off the glass, you know, the last couple games of this series, which is a true indication to me that, you know, he's maybe hitting a little bit of a physical wall himself. CJ McCollum, give him credit. You know, he's trying the best he can out there, but I think a lot of people forget that he's playing through a fractured disc in his back. That can't be easy. And you're starting to see his shooting percentages slip a little bit. Of course, it doesn't help either that you're playing against a Laker team that is one of the top teams defensively in the NBA this season. You put it all together, and you can see Portland is basically on the ropes right now, and the Lakers are about to deliver a knockout punch pretty much in that series. The other LA team, man, if they had their hands full with the Dallas Mavericks, of course, 3-2 in that series. Dallas will be facing elimination in Game 6 in the next game. We know, obviously, that Luka Doncic in Game 4 to tie the series at 2, that unbelievable performance of the ages, really, considering the situation. Team down 2-1, needing to win the game, playing through a very, very sore and tender ankle. And yet he went out there, poured in 43 points in the game, a winning buzzer beater in overtime. Just an unbelievable job by Luka Doncic. But the LA Clippers maybe got that wake-up call from that Game 4 overtime loss to Doncic and the Mavericks as they absolutely annihilated Dallas in Game 5. To take the 3-2 series lead. And Paul George, who broke the silence a day or two ago that a lot of his struggles throughout this series were due to some, you know, some depression, you know, some mental health struggles, you know, dealing with, you know, being in isolated, being in the bubble, and he said he wasn't really coping with it all that well, led to some struggles, but he apparently, again, this is all his words, he's talked with his teammates, tried to get, have people lend an ear to listen to what it, some of his concerns, and now he's feeling a little bit better, and that went a long way in terms of, you know, how he all of a sudden exploded out of this terrible shooting slump that he was in prior to game five, and obviously shot a lot better, played a lot better in that game. So it's going to be interesting to see, is the real Paul George back now for the LA Clippers? And if he's going to play like that moving forward, 30-plus points like he had in game five, obviously the LA Clippers are going to be a much better team. They're going to be a much more dangerous team. So it's going to be interesting to see how that ends up going moving forward. Denver Nuggets, Utah Jazz. We've got Denver making it a series, 3-2, Utah leading the series, but Denver stays alive with a game five win to force a game six. And my countryman, Jamal Murray, the pride and joy of Kitchener, Ontario, man, is this guy balling in this series. And if not for him, they're probably already done in this series, the Denver Nuggets. Jamal Murray has been awesome. There's no other way around it. Just making big shots, big plays, and big moments for the Denver Nuggets. Him and Donovan Mitchell in terms of just a one-on-one battle of two guys trying to one-up the other throughout this series. It's been a whole lot of fun to watch. Of course, Nikola Jokic is not far behind in terms of his impact and keeping the Denver Nuggets alive in this series as well. We know they're still somehow in this series and have their season alive, going to a game six, down 3-2 in this series, despite the fact they pretty much haven't played a lick of defense in this series. They've been just absolutely god-awful defensively at that end of the floor, the Nuggets, and yet somehow they're in this series. So dangerous for Utah. And if Denver wins game six when this series resumes over the weekend, all the pressure now is going to would shift to the Jazz in a seventh and deciding game. So if you're Utah, you're going to have to come out there and show that you want to put an end to this series, put an end to this Denver Nuggets team in game six. You don't want it to go to a game seven. Overs continue to cash in this series. It has been a over-trending series other than the one game, which I believe was game three. That was the only game to stay under the total. That's when Mike Conley returned for the Utah Jazz to their lineup. And again, he's more of a guy that's going to make an impact, improve you defensively. He gives you offense, don't get me wrong, but he's really good at the defensive end. So it's not surprising that first game with Conley back sort of went under the total. Remember, Denver just didn't show up as well in that game. If Denver even shoots somewhat better and has a little bit more interest in playing basketball, to be honest with you, in that game, it probably also would have went over the total. But nevertheless, it's been an over-heavy series. I've been betting some overs in that series, and it's worked out well between the Nuggets and the Jazz. So Denver, with the momentum, we'll see if they can ride it going into game six. And we'll wrap it up with, wow, has this series all of a sudden gotten interesting? Houston, Oklahoma City. Look, Oklahoma City couldn't have played worse in the first two games. And when they were down 2-0 after game two in this series, I thought to myself, you know what? Oklahoma City overachieved during the regular season. Nobody expected this team to be in the playoffs necessarily. Rebuilding organization, an over-the-hill Chris Paul, and a bunch of young players that maybe just needed some time to just get this ship back on the sails for a team that, Durant left years ago, and then Russell Westbrook in the offseason went to Houston. So it was a team that felt like they were in rebuild mode and weren't ready to be a playoff team this year, but they had a great regular season. I will give Billy Donovan credit. I got questions about Billy Donovan at playoff time, although, I'll give him credit there too. He was not only was he a good regular season coach for this Thunder team, one of the nominees for Coach of the Year, and he deserved it because nobody thought this Oklahoma City team was going to be this good, but he's also shown himself to be a very good playoff coach the last couple games. He's made some adjustments. He's gone to a smaller lineup. He says, you know what, Houston, you're not going to have much size in the interior, and you're going to have that small lineup. And Houston's been playing a small lineup up and down the court, shoot a lot of threes for months now. Really, with the lack of size and interior, they no longer have much in terms of low post size. And Oklahoma City said, we're going to try to fight fire with fire. We're going to throw a smaller lineup now at you, and let's see how you handle it. And then they get one of their best defenders back in Lugans Dort, another Canadian. I always got to throw that out there. But from Montreal, who's done a really much better job locking up the perimeter shooting of this Rockets team since he's been back. And that plus the lineup changes and configurations that Billy Donovan's made Plus, Chris Paul stepped up. He had a tough start to the series. He's been excellent the last two games. My Hamilton proud. You see the sign behind me. Nope, not proud. I can't possibly be prouder of any Hamiltonian from a sports athlete standpoint right now than Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. He has had a great season, a breakout year in the NBA, and he's played a lot better the last couple of games. And defensively, they've tightened the screws. And the mantra of this series has been, if you're Houston, you can't get into a close game, a tight game down the stretch late in the fourth quarter against this Oklahoma City team. The Thunder have been not just good, they have been amazing in these close games late in the fourth quarter, finding ways to execute, making shots, getting stops, and they have been able to win these close games. And Houston's found ways to lose these close games. Look at the two games Houston won in this series. They were blowouts. You know, they didn't have to worry about late game execution. In game three and game four, OKC won game three in overtime, and OKC pulled out a very close win in game four. Those were tight games down the stretch. It was up to James Harden and his teammates to execute late in crunch time, and they couldn't do it either time against Oklahoma City. So the goal for Oklahoma City is keep the game close late in the fourth quarter, and we can beat these guys because our late game execution has been better than theirs, period, flat out. Oklahoma City has done better in the last couple minutes of these games than Houston. That's got to be your mindset moving forward. However, part of my reasoning for saying Houston is going to struggle late in these games with execution compared to OKC is because there was no Russell Westbrook on the floor. You know, a guy that's really drives a lot of what the Rockets do successfully late in close games with his shot, you know, his decision-making, his penetration ability. You know, just being able to decide when do I pass, when do I shoot, running the offense in key times. And that was lacking big time, his presence in these close games for Houston in game three and game four. Well, now it looks like he's going to be back for game five. He is trending toward playing and returning from that injury for game five. So that changes things a little bit for Houston. They're probably better off from a late game execution standpoint if indeed Russell Westbrook returns in game five. That does make a world of difference, having him back on the floor if the game is close late. So all of a sudden, that edge that OKC had in these close late games, to me at least, when I handicap this series, it's not as big of an edge if Russell Westbrook does indeed return in game five. So it's a fascinating handicap moving forward. You know OKC's got the momentum, 2-2 now in this series, but down to a best of three. And all of a sudden, you know that thing called a noose? It's right around that Houston Rocket neck right now. Here we go again. Another playoff stumble. Another playoff. You know what job. You know, and you got to wonder, pressure on this team. Fertitta, the owner, I'm sure, is just can't believe it right now. We're in control of this series. We're up 2-0. It looks like we're going to sweep these guys. And now all of a sudden it's 2-2 in this series. So big pressure on Houston. Let's see how they handle it. In terms of this series from a betting standpoint, you know, I still think Oklahoma City's got a chance, and I'd be reluctant to bet against them as dogs. They're going to be in game five, you know, a 2.5, 3.5, maybe 4-point underdog, maybe a little bit higher if Westbrook plays. You might see the number shaded to Houston with Westbrook back. So you might see Oklahoma City around a 4, 4.5 point favorite in game, or sorry, Oklahoma City, a 4, 4.5 point dog. In game five of this series, if Westbrook plays. And, you know, I don't want to bet against OKC getting that. They have been, I think, 20-7 ATS as a 4.5 point underdog or less this year. They have been great in this point spread role. I like them kind of to before the series started. And I kind of soured on them after game two. And now I'm right back in there after the last two games, believing they've got a chance to beat the Rockets here in this series. I think if OKC sticks with the smaller lineup, and you know Houston plays that way, I think that this series is going to continue to trend toward a higher scoring series game to game. And now with Westbrook back, that guy is good for overs. You know, with the just how quick he is getting from end to end on the court and just ramping things up from a pace standpoint. And he's certainly going to be a boon to the offense for the Houston Rockets. I wouldn't surprise me to see a few more high scoring games here in this Rockets Thunder series, which is all of a sudden a very compelling and very intriguing watch moving forward with this series tied at 2 going into game 5. Before I wrap up this video, let's update you on some futures right now for NBA championship. Clippers plus 250, still currently the favorite to win the NBA title, even over the Lakers. And you could argue the Lakers have looked a little bit more impressive here in the first round than the Clippers have. But the Clippers plus 250 to win the NBA title. Lakers plus 275. Milwaukee Bucks plus 325. Then you have the Toronto Raptors, 7-1, plus 700. Boston Celtics plus 800. What a series that's going to be. I really think the team that wins that series could win the East. Raptors and Celtics, that'll be a phenomenal series. Can't wait to see it. Then you have the Houston Rockets, 15-1. Then here's the team that's got the value right now, in my opinion, coming up. The Miami Heat, 22-1, plus 2,200. If I'm going to bet a futures ticket right now, middle of the first round, if I'm going to bet a futures ticket right now to win the NBA title, that's the team I'm looking at, the Miami Heat, 22-1. They're going to play Milwaukee in the second round. They can beat Milwaukee. I like the way this team's trending. Spoelstra's done a great job. Duncan Robinson is on fire from three-point land. Goran Dragic is playing at a very high level. What a tandem him and Butler are now for this Heat team. Bam Adebayo in the low post. You know, they at least have some size with him and Olynyk and some others to combat the Greek Freak a little bit, at least try to make life a little bit more difficult and get the ball out of his hands. They give Milwaukee a hell of a series, in my opinion. And I think they've got a puncher's chance at even upsetting the Bucks in that potential second-round series matchup. And not potential. It's going to happen. Orlando's not coming back to beat Milwaukee. But that Milwaukee-Miami series is going to be phenomenal. That's the team I'm looking at right now. Certainly, value-wise, they're still out there, 22-1 in some books, Miami to win the NBA championship. Or you can even go just to win the East at plus 750 on Miami. But I think that's the value team. If there's one team that I think's got the value from a future standpoint right now in the NBA playoffs, it would be the Miami Heat. All right, thank you for watching. That's going to wrap up my Odds HQ NBA playoffs betting update. Hope you enjoyed it. Nice couple of days to take our breath, but also remember the bigger issues that are ongoing outside of sports. And it's been a good couple of days to just reflect on those. But nevertheless, I'm also very excited to have the NBA playoffs resume on Saturday. And I'll get back to the regular routine here starting on Saturday at odds.com and the Odds HQ YouTube channel. We'll have our daily video and article best bets. We'll resume those on Saturday. I've been just in unbelievable form with these plays on a daily basis here on the Odds HQ YouTube channel, and looking to continue that red hot form starting on Saturday. So hope you join me once again. As always, I'm Ian Cameron. Reminder to check out odds.com every day for great sports betting content, as well as the Odds HQ YouTube channel for fantastic live shows and videos daily from a sports betting perspective. Thank you for watching. Looking forward to the rest of the NBA playoffs, and I'll be back with you on Saturday as we resume my Odds HQ NBA betting preview videos. Thanks for watching, everybody.